This is analog signal sampling and reconstruction trainer. Order code of this trainer is 40513. On the panel you can see different blocks are given and circuit diagram of each block are shown on the panel. This is AF signal generator section. Circuit diagram for this section is given. This is minus 15 volt internally connected supply. This is plus 15 volt which is already internally connected. This is the output terminal of AF signal generator section. You can take the output of this section from these terminals. This is amplitude variable knob. You can change the amplitude of AF output with the help of this knob. This is frequency variable knob. You can change the frequency of output signal with the help of this potentiometer. This is frequency variable. This is modulator section. These terminals are input terminals of this section. These are the jumper setting. These jumper setting are provided for observation of different type of sampling. You can connect the jumper which is given in our manual. When you put J1 in closed condition and J2 and J3 are in open condition, then you will observe the natural sampling. And when you put J2 and J3 closed position and J1 open, this is flat top sampling. And when you put J1 open, J2, J3 closed, J1 open, J2 closed, and J3 open, then this is sample and hold sampling. This section is sampling clock generator. This is plus 5 volt internally connected supply. This is the output, sampling clock output. You can take the sampling clock output from this terminal and connect this terminal to sampling clock input of modulator section. This is gate pulse output. You can connect this gate pulse output to the input terminal of gate pulse of modulator section. So this is your sampling clock generator section. Circuit diagram of this section is given on the panel. So you can study the circuit diagram. This is demodulator section. This is PAM input pulse. This is PAM output. This output is to be connected to PAM input of demodulator section. Output of this demodulator section is available between these two terminals. These terminals are demod output terminals. So you can connect the output of modulator section to the input of demodulator section. You can demodulate the signal. So with the help of this trainer, you can study the different analog signal sampling and reconstruction. Let us start with experiment first. Experiment first is to generate PAM signal by modulating with audio signal by natural sampling. You can observe the different output with the help of CRO. So This is AF output and this is AF output. You can see on the CRO screen, this is your AF output, audio frequency output, output of AF signal generator section, common ground. This is sampling clock output. You can observe the sampling clock output to connect CRO at this terminal. This is your sampling clock output. This is your gate pulse output. Observe this gate pulse on CRO screen. This is your gate pulse output. So all signals are available. Now first connect for the experiment. First connect AF input terminal in modulator section. This is your modulator section and this is your AF input terminals. So positive upper side terminal, connect this terminal to AF output of AF signal generator section. Lower terminal is for ground terminal, which is already connected. You can also connect this terminal to ground terminal of AF signal generator. Adjust amplitude of sine wave. Connect the channel 1 of oscilloscope. This is for ground terminal and this is for positive. Now your channel 1 of CRO is connected at the output terminal of AF signal generator. Adjust the amplitude of sine wave to 2 volt peak to peak with the help of this knob. This is amplitude variable knob. With the help of this knob, you can set the output of AF signal generator to 2 volt peak to peak. Now this is 2 volt peak to peak. Audio frequency to 1 kilohertz. This is the frequency variable knob. With the help of this knob, you can set the frequency of audio signal to 1 kilohertz frequency. Remove this VNC cable from channel first and connect it to your frequency counter. And with the help of frequency variable knob, just set the frequency of this audio signal to 1 kilohertz. Now your frequency of audio signal is 1 kilohertz. Again connect this VNC cable to channel 1 of oscilloscope. Connect sampling clock output. This is sampling clock output. This is the terminal in the section of sampling clock generator. So connect this terminal to sampling clock input. Sampling clock input is the terminal which is available in modulator section. Connect gate pulse output. Sampling clock output. Connect gate pulse output. This is gate pulse output. Connect it to gate pulse input of modulator section. Connect CRO channel 2. This is the cable of channel 2 of CRO. Connect it to PAM output of modulator section. This is the PAM output terminals of modulator section. So connect the channel 2 of CRO between these two terminals. Now channel 1 is connected between the terminals of AF output in AF signal generator section, and your channel 2 is connected to PAM output of modulator section. Connect J1 link. These are the different jumper settings. So connect J1 link. J1 link is connected. Keep link J2 and J3 open. J2 and J3 are open. Observe the output waveform of modulator section on channel 2. This is your modulating signal, this is your audio frequency signal, and this is the output of modulator section which is available between the terminals of PAM output terminal. So this is your pulse amplitude modulated waveform. You can adjust with the help of CRO. This is your pulse amplitude modulated waveform. Upper waveform is modulating signal, audio frequency signal, and lower waveform is modulator output, that is pulse amplitude modulated output. So this is your experiment first. Now we are going to experiment second. For the experiment second, remove the all connections. First connect AF input terminal, same procedure. AF input terminal, this is AF input terminal to AF output terminal. You can connect ground terminal. Sampling clock input to sampling clock output. This is your sampling clock input. This is your sampling clock output. Gate pulse input, this is your gate pulse input to gate pulse output. Connect channel 2 at modulated output, this is your channel 1. So connect this channel 1 at AF output of AF signal generator. Now channel 1 is connected between the terminal of audio frequency output and channel 2. Connect channel 2 between the terminal of modulator section. Now jumper setting for this experiment, connect link J2 and J3. This is J2 and this is J3. Connect J3. Connect J2, keep link J1 open, this is J1, and keep this link open. The pulse amplitude modulated wave, switch on the unit. Adjust the frequency of sampling clock. This is the waveform of experiment second. You can observe this waveform with the help of this frequency adjustment, which is in sampling clock generator section. Now for experiment number third, keep the all connections same. The difference between the experiment second and third is jumper setting. For experiment number third, to generate PM signal by modulating with audio signal by sample and hold circuit. Second experiment is flat top sampling. For the experiment number third, connect link J2. This is J2. Keep link J1 and J3 open and observe the waveform on CRO screen. So this is the waveform for sample and hold circuit. Experiment number third, output of experiment number third. For experiment number second, connect J3 and J2. For experiment third, connect J2 and keep J1 and J3 open. Or for second, keep J2 and J3. Connect J2 and J3. This is your flat top sampling, experiment number second. And when you disconnect J3, only J2 is connected. This is your sample and hold circuit. So these are the waveform, different waveform which you can receive with the help of jumper setting. For natural sampling, keep J1 close, J2 and J3 open. For flat top sampling, keep J3 close, J2 close, J1 open. For sample and hold, keep J1 open, J2 closed and J3 open. And these are the different waveforms. Now to demodulate using low pass filter, to reconstruct input is sine wave. For the demodulation, disconnect the channel 2 of CRO and connect the channel 2 cable at the output terminals of demodulator section. Now your channel 2 is connected between the output terminals of demodulator section and connect the PAM output of modulator section to the PAM input of demodulator section. This is your PAM output terminal and this is PAM input terminal of demodulator section. Now your modulator is connected to demodulator section and you can see on the CRO screen, this is your input modulating signal, output of wave signal generator, and this is your received signal, output of demodulator section. This is your demodulated output. This is channel first, this is channel second waveform. So this is the experiment 4. All connections are same. For experiment 1 to 4, experiment 1 to 3, only jumper setting is changed. And for experiment 2, connect link J1. So for experiment 4th, you can connect the J1, keep link J2 and J3 open. and you can observe the demodulated output on the second channel of CRO. So this is your PAM output, demodulated output.